Tony Bastable at a school in South London asked some of the children, what is the Green Cross Code?
It's a way of crossing the road safely.
Well, it's a road safety thing. It tells you all about the road safety.
Well, that's a nice easy answer, but what does it say? Do you know what it says?
Splink.
Splink. Now, that's on the television commercial, isn't it? What does it stand for?
It stands for the Green Cross Code.
Yes, I know that, but what does it mean? What does the word mean?
It means how to cross safely and, actually, splink.
Yeah, what does splink mean?
First, stand on the pavement near the curb.
That's S.
Keep on the pavement near the curb. SB. if traffic is coming, let it pass.
You missed out L. What does the L stand for? Who knows what the L stands for in splink? Oh,
look all around and listen.
Yeah. You got to find a place without any cars.
Yeah.
Stand near the, stand on the pavement near the curb, not between parked cars. Look all around, look and listen around for traffic. If there's any traffic coming, don't cross. If there's traffic coming, if there isn't any traffic coming, don't cross.
Listen, and I don't go on my own really, I go with my mummy.
I'll look if there's loads of things coming, I'll just let it pass. If there's nothing at all coming, I'll walk along.
Now, why is it a bad idea to cross the road between cars?
Because the traffic can't see you.
Because the driver can't see you behind the cars. And if you go out there, they take you by surprise, knock you over.
Because the car comes like that, right? Then it's like that. When you're there, and the car comes like that, it can't see you there. You go like that, and it goes crash.
What you're really saying is that, because in case a car comes around the bend?
Yes.
Running across the road. How many of you run across roads? Come on, be honest. Nobody's going to admit that they've ever run... You've never, ever run across a road?
I have a couple of times.
Maybe if there was in a terrible rush, I was late for cubs or something, but... Not usually to school or somewhere like that.
Is it a wise thing to do, running across a road?
No, definitely not, because if you run too fast, the drivers can't see you properly, so they're not quite sure what it is.
Will you promise me that even if you are late for cubs, you won't run across any more roads?
OK.
That's an interesting priority, run to the cubs but not to school. But anyway, has the Green Cross Code really been a success? Let's ask one of Drive-In's motoring correspondents, Eric Dimmock. Eric, has it worked or hasn't it?
Well, the Transport and Road Research Laboratory looked into it. This year, they produced a report which said recall of specific items in the Green Cross Code was poor. It would seem to be a cause for concern that the Green Cross Code was not better known than the curb drill it was supposed to replace.
How big is this child casualty problem?
Well, only a quarter of the population are children, yet they make up half the pedestrian casualties.
So what's the report saying?
It's saying that when it was done, 16 months after it came out, of nearly 600 children interviewed, only three could give the code correctly, and quite a lot didn't know it at all. But the researchers thought it wasn't anything wrong with the code, more with how it was taught.
Well, with me in the studio is a headmaster, Ted Osborne. Ted, do you think you're not putting enough effort into teaching the Green Cross Code?
Oh, I think more effort can go into teaching the Green Cross Code, but the other part of this is how do children learn? And this is an essential question we have to ask this. We have found that young children, particularly young children, learn by direct involvement, by concrete experience. Mm. This is the way we would teach mathematics or science and things like this. Now the logic of this, the terrible logic, is that these children will learn better by being thrown into traffic. And of course we can't allow that. So I would say what we need to do is to get at the minds of adults, parents and teachers.
But you don't feel that the code is too complicated to understand?
The code itself you can learn by rote, but whether you understand it is a different matter.
Well, let's take this point up with Edwin Corkell from ROSPA, the Royal Society for the Prevention of Accidents. Now, you introduced the curb just as long ago as 1942, Mr. Corkell. Why did you think it was necessary to change it?
Well, it was taught as a drill, just as some people are attempting to teach the Green Cross Code as a drill. And as a drill, it's more or less meaningless. It's not applied. It's not even understood. It didn't tell anyone anything about finding a safe place to cross the road. It said nothing about continuing to watch while you cross the road. And in fact, it had other faults as well.
But at least they could learn it. Now, are you right to change something which a kid still remembers, even from way back, to something which they just don't seem to be able to grasp? From that film, they couldn't remember what the actual things were of the Green Cross Code, could they?
No, that's recalling is not learning. Learning is applying. And I think that all those children we saw on that film just now did in fact know the Green Cross Code. They knew the essential things, they knew how to cross the road. Being able to recall the exact words does not matter in the least. In fact, I very much doubt if they'd ever been taught the exact words. What they have been taught is how to behave properly on the road, how to find a safe place, how to look for traffic, and how to cross the road. The two things are entirely different.
That's a good point. That's a very good point. Now, what about your children? How have they learned to cross the road?
Well, I think they learn in actual conditions as far as we can approximate them. You know, I feel that the Green Cross Code or crossing a road has to be taught where it's happening. That the parent bringing the child to school should tell the parent what she is doing. Constantly, to repeat this, we in school would link the knowledge of this with any circumstance in the school that would attract children, that would be meaningful to children. And I must support the point of view that merely being able to recall words from the Green Cross Code doesn't really mean that children understand in conceptual terms what it's all about.
But what you're basically saying is that the Green Cross Code is really for parents, for adults, for teachers and people like that, rather than for the children themselves.
I'd say it was a guide to parents and teachers, yes. And teachers and parents apply it as best they can when they're teaching children how to cross the road.
But then why give it names like Green Cross Code and this thing Splink, which to me didn't mean a thing?
Well, Splink, I'm afraid, I regard as nonsense. Mm. And the thing has to be given some sort of name, and that was, in fact, the name given to it.
How are we going to get across this problem, though, of teaching children in the actual spot, on the road itself, without having accidents?
Well, it can be done, and it has been done in this country, and much more so in Sweden, where children in small groups, 10 to 15 children, are taken with teachers beside the road, and there they discuss the conditions.
So what we might indeed see a change in the teaching, I hope so, anyway. Eric,
yes,
you've got a 7-year-old, a fairly lively 7-year-old. Does he keep to the Green Cross Code exactly?
Well, not exactly. He doesn't, because I've asked him. But he certainly follows the general strategy. It's very difficult, I think, getting children to understand how important this whole thing is. They think if you get knocked down by a car, you just get up again.
It's not as easy as that, is it? Well, there you go. What's it going to be? Is the Green Cross Code right? Should we be back on curb drill or should we not? Gentlemen? Thank you for joining in the discussion. Join me next week on the Brighton Run in a Rolls Royce. See you then. Bye-bye.